Hey guys, what's up? This is Jinx Rose, and welcome back to another Minecraft Hardcore Challenge. This one is called Defend the Village. So, in this one, we have to save the village, defend it from the invading zombie hordes, have to remain in the village at night. Most of the old rules apply, all of the old rules apply, no AFK anything, everything has to be on camera, no sleeping in beds, no harming passive mobs unless they've been replaced by breeding, which shouldn't be an issue because we already have a massive farm right here for us, which is friggin' sweet. So I'm gonna collect all the food that is ready and then explore the rest of the village really quickly to see if there's anything useful for me. Probably won't have to actually build much of anything, if I have to build anything at all. Inside this village, there are so many farms. Like, there's no... Oh, hey, zombie! I don't know how many villagers we are starting off with, either. It'd be easiest for me to tell after... After night has fallen and they all start going inside their homes and stuff. And then we'll know how many villagers we've saved at the end. Or kept alive, rather. Maybe not saved. So that's plenty of food for now. And that's really what I expect. Oh, what the crap was that lag all about? And that's really what I expected, was to have a ton of food. Surviving in this is not going to be difficult by any means. So, let's check these, make sure there's nothing in it. And there probably is a chest in here. There is. With 3 apples, a saddle, 6 oak saplings, 2 diamonds already, an iron ingot, and some bread. I wish that would have been one more diamond. That would have been really nice. So, first things first, let's find either some trees. Okay, there's trees out there, so that's where we're going. actually, we can just do this. I'll just steal these. That's fine. As long as I don't break the blocks that where the water is being held back by, then it's fine. There's also mushrooms over there. Yeah, there's no way we're going to starve in this one or even come close to it. So we'll turn that into planks. Get a crafting table laid out. And get some sticks. Give me those. Let me see. I guess I'll just make it out of wood first. Make an axe out of wood. And then get the rest of this wood here. So what we want to do right off the bat is make sure that each home has a door and that it is secure. Literally right off the bat, that's exactly what we want to do. We also want to make sure that... Oh no, I just did exactly what I told myself I wasn't going to do. Alright, here we go. Boom. Done. Okay. I forgot what I was going to say. We want to explore, we want to go mining, but we can't stay down in the mine. Sorry, my throat's freaking killing me today. We can't stay down in the mine overnight. We have to be up here in the village protecting the villagers overnight, which actually gives us plenty excuse to run around and kill a bunch of enemies as well. But first things first, I want to make sure every single house in this place has a door. And another thing is, like, this challenge is not to see how well you can build onto the village and get more villagers to spawn and stuff like that. This is literally just to protect the village that's already sitting here. So, that's what we're going to do. I'm going to finish this one out. I'm not going to go through the center and get those... get that wood. Actually, you know what? I will. There's no point in it being here. I love it when I find villages because there's wood constantly. Everywhere you go, as long as there's a farm, there's wood and you don't have to go exploring, which is nice. We will need some stone, though. But let's get all of this... Actually, let's keep like 5 of it for coal. And then actually 9 of it for coal. The rest of this turned into planks. That way we can build some doors. I wish this was 1.8. Or, yeah? 0.8? I don't know. The one where there's multiple doors. Like, where every time you craft a door, you get some... I don't remember what it is. 4, 6, something like that. But for now, let's make 5 doors, and let's make sure that all these houses have doors. And then I'm going to start putting torches up. At 6, but whatever. Then we're going to start putting some torches up, and I'm going to plant some trees around the city, around the village, so we don't have to go exploring too far. So let's check all the houses. This house has a door. And another one of the rules, it's not really a rule, I don't think, but another one of the stipulations is to only have like one door per house, because the more doors you have per house, the more villagers will spawn. So there's that. Let's make sure the rest of these have... I just gotta find a good path to be able to make sure that all of them have doors. I think this is the right way to go. So this one has a door, it's fine. That one has a door, it's fine. Some of these will have doors, some of these will not. And I want to make sure that each house has a door. This one did not, so there we go. This one does not. This one does. There should be plenty of time left for me to make a bunch of torches as well. Let's lay down... Let's collect some gravel here. Lay down the gravel right there, so they can get up inside this house. There we go. And I think there's one more. Yeah, one more house, which has a door. So all the houses have doors. So now let's run back over here to the furnace. And we will make some... We will craft some charcoal. And we will make some torches from that. That should help quite a bit. And then also, I'm just going to cook up these potatoes so I have something to eat. We can always get more planks, so that's not something for me to worry about at this point. And we'll make some torches. And then start at one end of town like we already did and put some torches in front of the houses. I want to make a bunch of torches, actually, just to protect everything. So basically, we're just getting all this fortified right now. Now, what I'd like to do is make a door in front of each door and make like a little mud room or a hallway. It makes it harder for the zombies to get in and mess with people, but that I think would spawn more villagers, and I'm not supposed to be doing that, so. So that's 20 torches. Villagers. Okay, he's willing to trade for chicken. You. Bread. Hey, you. 11 emerald for an iron chest plate. No, thank you. And there's plenty of stone for us to gather up around here, too. I could literally just tear the well apart. In fact, I think I might. For no real reason. The well doesn't really serve a purpose. I don't think. Let me know if it does. Let me know if, like, you get rid of the well and then everybody dies off or something crazy like that. Before I go tearing it down. And before the sun goes down, because I have to be here when it does, I really want to go collect some stone. So I'm first off gonna just look around for any natural like cavern areas. Looks like I might have something over this way. I should not run. That is a bad idea. Also make some more torches. Aha! Natural cavern. Perfect. I left my crafting table in the town, so I'll just do this. And get myself a wooden pickaxe for now. Get enough stone to make a stone pickaxe. Just 3 is all I'm going to need. And then I'm going to make a stone pickaxe. I should also make a stone sword as early as possible. I don't need that anymore. There we go. Stone sword as early as possible. There we go. And then I'll also make an iron sword as quick as I can, too. Because I know there's going to be a lot of fighting in this one. There's a good chance I might die in this one. I don't know. I'm hoping it'll at least be interesting, though, guys. Even if I die, it'll at least be an interesting ride until I do. I think the village is fairly safe for now. I mean, we've got doors on every building. I will be laying down torches before night falls if I can... If I can remember to make my way back before night falls. Oh, jeez, creeper. Yeah, buddy. Zombie. Zombie. Oh, man, I thought I was going to fall down there. Fall down to a deeper depth. Okay, well, there's plenty of coal for me to collect down here, but I want to be safe, too. And let's check the level of the sun as well. Where are we at? Oh, man, we are setting. Okay. So in front of each home, and I've got plenty of food, so I might as well run. In front of each home, I'm going to do at least a torch. Just for now. And then there's torches on these guys. And I can make some more of those, some more makeshift ones of those. There's nothing in the rules that stated that we can't go inside of the homes. So I think I might end up doing that. And then I'll make some more torch lights around the roads. Hey, villagers. Get inside. It's nighttime. Also, early on, I want to make an iron golem. Simply because it'll help me protect this village even further. And I don't think I'll need, like, any iron armor or anything like that right off the bat. Well, maybe. I will be fighting a lot. I don't know. We'll figure it out. We'll decide what's going on. There's another little cavern crevasse over here. Dude, villagers, get inside right now. What the hell is your problem? Hey, skeleton. What's up, man? I see you there. I see you. Ah! Ah! Thank you. Hopefully I can get a bow, too. That'd be nice. Alright, let's eat. Dude, get inside a house, man. Should have saved the apple, actually. I have plenty of potatoes. Hey, zombie. Oh, you're a zombie villager. I shouldn't have killed you. There'll be more of you, though, I'm sure. Nothing was mentioned in the rules about turning zombie villagers or villager zombies into villagers, so I might do that. If I can remember the process by which to do that. If that sentence made any sense, I'm not sure. Right now I'm just laying down torches and making sure that people don't, enemies don't spawn like right in town, basically. It seems fairly safe for the first night, although the villagers are kind of stupid. They really should get inside. They don't do that kind of thing on their own, apparently. Which is stupid. Alright, we're lighting it up pretty good. Get inside, guys! You guys are stupid. There's an enderman out that way. I don't want to stare at him. But he's there. Okay. I think our torches are laid out pretty good right now. Yeah, we should be okay. I'll put one here. So we've got it lit up really well, actually. Which is nice. This is kind of dark over here. Hi, spider! What's up, man? Don't mess with me, spider! So, food isn't an issue. Defending the villagers shouldn't be too bad if they get their asses inside. Because they are dumb. And I don't remember if Michael Deering said anything about, like, building a wall to surround the village. If I might spend a majority of the episodes doing that. Remind me in the comments if I can or cannot. Somebody. Michael Deering, if you're watching this, that'd be awesome. Remind me in the comments. Can I build a huge, massive wall surrounding the entire village to prevent anything from getting in? If so, I think I could do that in just a couple of episodes, probably. Doom, doom. This music's awesome. I wish to breed the cows. Okay. I have a plan. This would be the first episode, I think. And I guess in the last episode I bred some chickens. But I think this will be the first episode where I breed, like, larger animals. Oh, hey, buddy. You can get away from these houses. How's about that? You get away. Get your face out of here. Alright, dude, get inside. Man, I'm gonna smack you. Get inside. Get in there. Get in there. Go. Get inside. You're dumb. Hate you, villagers. Did you just... Oh my god, you're coming back outside. Good god, they're dumb. We're lit up really well. There's a bunch of endermen around. Other than that, things are looking pretty good. Okay, what was I doing? I want to find my crafting bench. That's what I was doing. I could easily build a new one, but there's really no point. I've already got one laying around here somewhere. Oh, give me your butter boots. Give me a butter suit. I need it. I need your butter suit. Give me it now. Give me it now. Give me the butter suit. Yeah. Oh, only a helmet, but still. Better than nothing. And it's worn out pretty bad. Oh, God. A lot of fighting. At least my health will regenerate because I've got plenty of food. Let's take care of... Let's take care of building a fenced-in area for these cows. Actually, that's what I'm kind of getting at. Hey, dude, spider, come on, man. Come on, man. Get out of my face. Thank you. Alright, my health should regenerate fine now. I don't remember where the heck my crafting bench is, so I'm just going to build a new crafting table. That's fine. And let's build it in here. Right here. Perfect. And fencing, I need a ton of sticks for that. Dude. If you guys got inside buildings, you wouldn't have to worry about zombies chasing your asses down. Come on. Oh, jeez. Oh, man. Oh, wow. My health. Holy crap, my health. All right, okay. I'm going to hide out inside this house, and then I can just close the door if something bad happens. I should build a small fenced-in area. And then we'll build a gate. That should work. Actually, that's way too small of a fenced-in area. We need way more than that. I'm going to do this. Perfect. And that. 22, maybe. Maybe that's good enough. If we build it onto the side of a building, we'll be able to save some as well. So, I'll build it right here. Building in a fenced in area. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hopefully my math is right. Oh yeah, that's plenty. Okay. Let's get some cows in here. Cows. There's always plenty of them until you need them, and then they're nowhere to be found. Cows! Gurgurn here. Yeah, there's still plenty of them. Cows, come on. Let's go. This cow, too. Hey, come on. Alright, three cows, that'll be good. That's a good start. Two cows, because this guy lost. He's not paying any attention to me anymore. Okay, fair enough. That skeleton's eyeing me down. Get in here, guys. Get in here. Come on. Get in here. Come on. Jeez. Alright, and you two, breed immediately. Yes. So, there we go. I've got that started. So, there's no way I'm running out of food now. Moon is going down. Sun is coming up. I'm going to collect a bunch more food stuff just because I can. And then in the next episode, depending on whether I actually can or not, I'm going to build a giant wall surrounding this place. If that's even a possibility for me. So, but anyway, for right now, we can just gather up a bunch of goodies. Probably should be out killing a bunch more enemies. And I didn't count and see how many villagers there are in this village. I'm sure somebody else in their video will tell me. If I don't know if the world will spawn the same or not. I'm not entirely sure. Should, but I'm not sure the amount of villagers will be the same or whatever. Oh, there's my little crafting bench. Let's get that. And I'll just carry it around on me. Definitely want this. Because then I'll be able to craft stuff wherever I am. Alright, let's take out this guy. Oh, jeez. I just tore down a bunch of wheat. Killed him, though. Alright, and the spider. The sun is almost completely up. The moon is basically down. So I think that's going to be it for this episode, guys. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. Check out Michael Deering's channel. He's the guy who comes up with all these challenges, and they're friggin' awesome every time. Check out the other people who are taking place in these hardcore challenges. There's some pretty cool people. And I think yeah, that's going to be it, guys. I will see you guys in the next one.